This video contains some of the latest recommendations from the 2018 ADA Clinical Practice Guideline on Nonrestorative Treatments for Carious Lesions. Silver diamine fluoride, or SDF, has been used in other countries for decades. SDF is safe for tooth decay across the age spectrum and is a non-invasive way to treat carious lesions without the need to drill and fill. In 2014, the United States Food and Drug Administration cleared SDF for use as a desensitizing agent, and that makes the treatment available for use off-label for caries arrest. This has led to a call for national guidance. An expert panel convened by the ADA reviewed the scientific evidence to provide recommendations on the use of non-restorative treatments for carious lesions. The panel recommends the use of 38% SDF to arrest advanced cavitated carious lesions on any coronal surface of primary teeth and suggests the use of 38% SDF to arrest advanced cavitated carious lesions on any coronal surface of permanent teeth. Additionally, to arrest or reverse non-cavitated and cavitated carious root lesions on permanent teeth in patients for whom the use of once-a-day 5,000 parts per million fluoride toothpaste or gel is not feasible, the expert panel also suggests the use of 38% SDF. Let's begin the exam by asking your patient if any new dental or medical issues have emerged since their last exam. Next, perform a full clinical exam and consider the use of a caries risk assessment approach. While conducting your clinical exam, you may identify one or more tooth surfaces exhibiting cavitated lesions. A cavitated lesion is denoted by a carious lesion with a surface that is not macroscopically intact and with a distinct discontinuity or break in the surface integrity. Upon identification of a cavitated lesion, SDF can be considered as an intervention to arrest carious lesions. Make sure to discuss the effects of SDF with patients. Patients receiving SDF will want to know how their teeth may feel after its application, whether there will be a need for reapplication or subsequent appointments, and why black stains may appear in the sites where SDF is applied. These black stains may not be acceptable to some patients, parents, or caregivers. Therefore, clinicians should explain all non-restorative and restorative options, along with their potential adverse effects. Clinicians should also request oral or written informed consent from all patients before treatment. Once SDF application is agreed upon, it's important to follow the proper four-step process. Step 1. Carefully set up your workstation. Clinician and patient should protect their eyes and only a drop or two of SDF solution is needed for treatment. Step 2. Check the cavitated lesion for food residue or gross plaque. If present, remove it with a microbrush or cotton pellet till exposed dentin is visible. Dry the side of the lesion by patting down the area with gauze or cotton. Step 3. With the site now clean and dry, brush SDF onto the exposed dentin. Move the tongue and lips as necessary and use careful strokes. If needed, remove excess solution with gauze. Step 4. Allow SDF to dry on the lesion for 1 minute if possible, making sure that the lesion site does not come in contact with the gums, tongue, or lips. As the SDF dries, you will likely see the lesion darken. The patient should be monitored short-term, and reapplication of SDF should occur within 6 months to a year. Treatment can be concluded when the treatment surface is hard upon probing. This indicates that the lesion is arrested and not progressing. Let's review the key takeaways. Practice informed consent. Prior to SDF application, explain potential side effects such as the blackening of tooth surfaces treated with SDF. Ensure that patients and their caregivers are aware of all non-restorative and restorative treatment options available. Minimize future caries risk. Talk with patients about how home care, such as routine brushing with fluoride toothpaste and interdental cleaning, can help minimize the need for future treatment. Follow up. After initial SDF application, carious lesions should be retreated with SDF every 6 months or annually. Patients should be monitored periodically throughout the course of treatment so that changes in lesion hardness, texture, and color can be observed. Lesion hardness is the definitive outcome, and hardness upon probing should be clearly observed. For more information on the ADA's clinical recommendations, visit ada.org/caries.